going on and statistics going on and different countries spiking right now is just, it is a time of chaos in terms of our own sense of well-being. And now that they're finding, it's wild that people are having more emotional and mental illness through this and through this whole period, you know, because it's been going on since the beginning of March, and it's a long time to feel like you don't know, you know, like you're walking on eggshells and you don't know what to do or how to live or whether we're ever going to get back to a new norm, you know. So I'm glad to do this little short workshop so that people can just have a little bit of tools to find their way to the peace that's in the core of all this madness going on around the world.
Matthew, what's the name of your sponsor?
Dylan Newcomb.
Oh yes, Dylan Newcomb. Sorry, I'm sorry to keep track with the channel.
A lot going on, a lot happening, a lot of good stuff.
So we're just getting to the minute of the hour, and we will be starting promptly. Welcome, everybody. There's links in the chat there being posted. So if you keep up with the links, they have useful information. And it's all up. Welcome, very warm welcome here in the coaching and therapy channel. I'm so excited we have Brandon Bay today with us. Before we get started, I'd like to play a very short video from our wonderful sponsor, Dylan Newcomb, who's sponsoring the Coaching and Therapy channel. So my lovely co-host Alina, whenever you're ready, you can play the sponsorship video.
Welcome to the Coaching and Therapy channel. So this channel is quite close to my heart because I train coaches and embodiment. I mean, why? Org. And even easier, he's got an embodied assessment there.
You can purchase, you'll find the link in the chat for purchasing the library. And welcome, Brandon Bay. So happy. So good to have you with us.
Heartfelt namaste to everyone. And it's such a great gift that you're offering to life and to humanity during this time when we need as many tools as we can get in this area. So thank you with all my heart for letting me join in.
It's our pleasure. For those of you who are tuning in for the first time, Brandon is a world leading authority on emotional healing and life transformation. She's the pioneer of the Journey Method. You can find links for her in the chat as well. She's an international best-selling author of several books. And today, the subject of our talk is finding peace amid the chaos. I certainly want to know more about that. So I'll give it over to you, Brandon.
Yes, well, during this time, and I don't know where you're all, you know, coming from, but it's been a wild time ever since the COVID came out. And one of the things that we know about our emotions is that when we feel that science has found this, and they can see this in a laboratory, is that when you feel a strong emotion and you repress it, it releases a quantifiable biochemistry into our bloodstream, which will go to certain cell receptors and block them, rendering those cells incapable of communicating with the rest of the cells in the body. And if over time illness happens, it happens where the cells are blocked. And what we also conversely know to be true is that when we feel our emotions very openly and freely, like a child does, our cell receptors remain open. And so what's happened during this wild time where I've called the talk, you know, finding peace amidst the chaos. And it's a wild time where it's almost as if the rug has been pulled out from underneath us. And we've been in various stages of lockdown, depending on which country you're from and how draconian that lockdown was for you. And it meant that suddenly these buried emotions that are actually stored in our cells, and that programming is being passed on from one cell generation to another. What's happening is that we are getting triggered and we're not being given answers. We don't know when the new norm is coming. Our worst survival fears are coming up. Am I going to have a job after this when furlough completely is over? Is there going to be a job waiting for me at the end? Should I be going into work, even though they say I can go into work? Is it safe to do so? What about my children, them going to school, and now the teachers' union is saying they want to go into full lockdown during half term? And so it's every day. The news is different depending on which country you're from. And what's happening, it's like a pressure cooker. And no one gave us a manual. How do you deal with something where for months on end, you're living in the unknown? You don't know what the next day is going to bring. You feel that there's danger and to your health, to the health of your loved ones, and that there's danger for your livelihood, even just your ability to play and get out there and have fun and travel. All of that's been limited down and has created this kind of pressure cooker for all of us. And we are getting triggered. And what happens, a loved one says something which wouldn't have really just kind of rolled off our shoulders in the past, and it pushes our buttons, and up comes the rage or the frustration or the fear or the exasperation. And it's not like that loved one came in the middle of the night and stuck those emotions inside of you. Those emotions are already living in your cells. All that they've done is push a button, and up comes the rage. So it can be the kind of thing that you're in Israel, and in Tel Aviv, they have crazy traffic there, and someone cuts you off in traffic, and up comes the road rage. Again, that person didn't put it inside you. It was already there, and it's then giving rise to itself. And so this is the situation we're all in, where with us getting triggered, we, none of us, were given the tools of how to deal with that. And the journey was first born from my own direct experience, from healing from what was a basketball-sized tumor. And in only 6.5 weeks' time, without medical intervention or drugs or surgery. And the gift of that healing journey for me was that I found a method for all of us to go on our own healing journeys inside of our bodies, to get access to these old cell memories, to these trapped emotions, that old programming that got stored inside your cells. And not only to get access to those old cell memories and that old pain, that when we had that strong emotion and we shut it down, it released that biochemistry. It went to those cell receptors, and the journey takes you to those cellular locations where you can uncover what's stored there in a gentle but quite powerfully releasing way, go through a radical and very deep process of releasing what's stored there and also coming to understanding why it got buried there, and going through a deep process of forgiveness, so that when new cells are born, they're born devoid of that old programming as new regenerative cells. And so at first I was invited, you know, this all happened 27 years ago, that I had this tumor. And over the years, what happened as the journey was born, and then the international bestseller came out and is now being used widely in 39 countries, is I've seen what works with people. And as we've worked with all different kinds of issues, emotional and physical, I've also seen what doesn't work. And so now the journey is being used in hospitals, by medical doctors, to get to the emotional root cause of what is co-creating the illness alongside whatever medical treatment people may be getting. So for instance, there's two hospitals, actually three now in Tel Aviv, where after you've gone through heart surgery, you'll have a week's recovery program where the center of that program is that they undergo the journey to get to the emotional corollary of what co-created the heart disease in the first place. They have also an oncology unit where after your treatment, you then undergo that recovery program so that you don't have that illness coming up again later on down the line. So you're really clearing the consciousness of what co-created the illness. They also have that for fibromyalgia in a third hospital where they have the recovery program to get to the emotional root cause of what is co-creating the illness in the first place. And as a matter of fact, if you get on the CDC, I think most of us are aware of what that is, the Center for Disease Control's website, you'll see there that it says 85% of all illness has an emotional basis. And the reason they can say that is because of all the work going on in the field of cellular healing. And part of the great gift of my own healing journey was finding this means, this method, a very practical one that I've been using in with ministries of education around the world or with medical doctors and in hospitals and with psychiatrists, psychologists, and people from all walks of life, is it puts the tools in your hands to really participate in your own healing journey. And obviously my prayer is for you that you don't wait till life gives you a wake-up call, you know, because for me, I was in the field of personal growth. I had been certified in many aspects of complementary medicine. I was a presenter for the Living Health Seminar for Tony Robbins, where I was giving that 5-hour workshop on the Monday night after he was giving the weekend seminar. And so it was, you know, my whole life was dedicated to health and to feeling vibrant. And at the time when I got ill, I'd moved from New York City, my hometown, to Malibu, California. And I was living, I mean, talk about embodiment, walking my talk. Organic vegetarian food. I was working out every day, breathing that fresh sea air. And I was in a job where I felt passionate about what I was teaching people, which was how to create vibrant health in a very practical, down-to-earth way. And not only that, but I'd been not only through all the training, but certified and was practicing it as therapist in my life. And I was in a marriage I felt deeply blessed to be in, a beautiful family life. And you could say that at the age of 39 years old, I felt myself to be at a peak of my life. I felt vibrant, healthy, alive, grateful. And the last thing I ever expected to have happen was for my tummy to start to grow. And I just didn't want to believe it was happening to me, because after all, I was doing everything right. And it finally got to a point where I couldn't zip up my trousers, and it was growing. I could see where it was growing. And one day I was sitting for meditation, and I'd been meditating since I first learned meditation when I was 19 years old at a university. And I know many of you who are watching this meditate, and you know there could come a point in meditation where your mind starts to wind down and falls into the background. And I was just resting in this thought-free stillness, and out of nowhere came a gut knowing I might be seriously ill. And then I needed to get real and get myself to an Orthodox medical doctor so I could have this tested and diagnosed. And when I came out of that meditation, I was just overwhelmed with shame. And I thought, my God, you're going around the world with Tony Robbins and you're teaching 5,000 to 6,000 people a night how to create vibrant health, and you might be seriously ill. And I felt so much shame that I didn't have the guts to call up my best friend to ask to go to the kind of specialist she was going to. Instead, I went to the local bookshop where in the Barnes & Noble down there in Santa Monica, and I went to the women's section because I could see where the weight was gained. And I pulled down a book written by a surgeon who did not recommend hysterectomies. And when I call the number at the back of the book,